Senator, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill.
So let's talk about the gas tax, Senator. I was lamenting the fact that the opposition party could not even agree on opposing the gas tax, despite the fact that poll after poll shows that almost two-thirds, and more than two-thirds in some polls, of New Jersey doesn't want another tax. What do you think?
Well, Bill, elections are about bold contrast between you and your opposition. And when you have an intersection of good policy and good politics, you need to jump on that. And clearly, the voters of New Jersey are strongly opposed to a gas tax increase. This information was available to all the folks running for the assembly this year. And in my opinion, the Republicans should have jumped on it 100% opposition to this gas tax. It was opposed by a huge number of Republicans, 69% of independents, and even 57% of Democrats. So the way you drive people to the polls is make them passionate. And they were passionately opposed to a gas tax increase, and we totally blew it. The Republicans missed a great opportunity to drive our voters to the polls and have them elect Republicans. So it really ticks me off because now it's setting it up for a gas tax increase in New Jersey.
So how do you do it? So now from the perspective in the Senate, you and I were talking the other day about that the Republicans, their way out is they're going to try to claim that, well, don't worry, we reduced the estate tax, even though we gave you a gas tax. And I'm going to tell you, as a taxpayer, as a voter, as a homeowner in New Jersey, I don't care about the estate tax. That's not driving me to the polls. That's not driving me to get upset one way or the other. I do care about my weekly bills. And the question is, can you separate it? Because I think both parties need to be called out on this, that we're not going to let them get away with just the empty rhetoric of saying, don't worry, we gave you one tax, but we took away another. How do you do it?
Bill, this is the most probably the most important thing I'm going to say regarding this linkage. This linkage would be a disaster for the people of New Jersey, and I'll tell you why. Because it's going to allow both parties to have status quo as usual regarding the construction costs on our roads. You've probably mentioned it, but the Reason Foundation recently issued a report, and New Jersey is spending per mile of road construction 12 times the national average.
Almost $2 million, right? A mile.
$2 million per mile. So instead of spending a dollar to get something done, we're spending 12. And then a lot of folks have said, well, New Jersey's a dense state, and we have a lot of lanes per mile. But when you compare to New Jersey to similar states that have similar densities, such as Massachusetts, we're spending $2 million a mile, Bill. Massachusetts is spending one-third of that, about $667,000 per mile. So what's going to happen here by linking the gas tax and the estate tax, we're never going to have the discussion about how this new gas tax money is going to be spent. And that's the critical conversation because, as you know, there's two sides of the equation, the money coming in and how the money is spent. And until we know why we're 12 times the national average, why we're four times what New York State is spending per mile, we're spending $2 million. How does New York do it for $500,000? Aren't the people in Trenton, isn't Governor Christie, aren't you concerned about why we're spending so much? And shouldn't we, before we ask the people to pay one more dime of higher tax, find out why we're spending so much?
You know,
nobody wants to know, apparently.
You're right. I lived in Massachusetts. And when I lived there, it was called Taxachusetts. And now you look at the comparison between New Jersey and Massachusetts. I think it's cheaper to live there. I mean, it's nuts. And I agree with you. I don't know. I have to believe it has something to do with the unions and the prevailing wage. But my guess is it's not just what the workers are earning. It's the bureaucracy. It's the way we do our contracts. It's the how these contractors get through the system. There must be just piles of regulation that the average person just doesn't know about.
Well, I agree, Bill. You know, prevailing wage does add to the cost about 30 to 40% of doing a job when you have prevailing wage. But we're not talking 30 to 40%. We're talking 1,200% more than the national average. We're talking 300% more than Massachusetts. So this prevailing wage, it's easy to poke a stick at that, and maybe we should look at that. But how much are we spending for the raw materials, asphalt, concrete, rebar? How much are we spending for engineering costs, architecture costs, environmental studies, administering these projects, equipment leasing? You know what, Bill? We're shooting into the dark. And if a business was run by, like the state of New Jersey is, on these road construction projects where we have no idea why we're spending so much, the whole crew running that business would be fired. So we owe it to the people. I have introduced legislation to create a task force of people in industry, people in government, to find out why we're spending so much more than these other states. And that should be a first step before we turn around and ask the people to pay a penny more in a higher gas tax.
I love it. State Senator Mike Doghtery, thank you for your perspective. I appreciate exactly how you're approaching this issue. Please send me any links to any of these bills that you're pushing out there. I want to get this out on Twitter and have this conversation, and we'll definitely have you on again. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you, Bill.
Appreciate it. Have a great day.